person conceded. And Runeterra is a super fun game.
Willow versus Fireheart.
Ha! The headmaster wouldn't let you research his afternoon snack. I hope you don't mind. I'm winning this whole thing.
Hey, thanks for breaking your rule and gifting a sub over to T-Town Guy. Thank you so much, Dietak. It is funny. So the reason that Dietak asks people to speak is because the way he gives subs is he clicks on your name and then gives a sub to you. For a long time, he thought that that was...
No shame in learning.
He did claim that you thought that that was the only way you could do it for a while, right? Okay, so I lose if this stays up, so that's why I'm gonna Hysteria it. So, well, part of the issue with explaining my plays is I typically don't know why I do. Which can make it difficult to explain something that I don't know why I did it.
It's perfectly wise to me.
Could you repeat that? I'll write that down.
Dietak, what do you mean arousing that the pretzel clip? Yeah, I don't know how Dietak hasn't seen that before, because it's been around a really long time.
Never be afraid of your inner power.
But yeah, like, Throder and Hoots use it all the time.
Put some soul into it.
How over? He's only overloaded for. Raider Die Attack. Thank you so much for the support today. I appreciate it. We are minion based, so recycling isn't terrible. If we were running two separate one drops that go to 3/3s, I'd be a little bit more willing. Or like the Minari Masher, or whatever the two drop is, but we're not running that two.
Willow versus Omu.
Witness the ways of my forest.
Just a warning. I have a black thumb.
Here for the tour?
It's just an old deck paradox. He was overloaded quite a bit last. I'm not that interested. This is probably better to play. I was just like, they're kind of similar. Thank you. Right, well, I mean, this summons a fly move. I mean, you still get a demon. With my hero power. Oh, he's gonna regret that.
It's beautiful.
Okay, he seems like he's got something that can hurt us. Harbor Up Savage probably kills us, right? And oh no, it'd be one off. Savage Roar kills us.
Time is of the essence.
One, two, three, four, five, six, ten.
Happy that the pit is churning.
It's actually less hard.
You got burned. You got burned.
The nose knows.
Yeah, no, the demon's buckets aren't great. They send you down a bad path.
versus Fireheart.
Ha! The headmaster wouldn't let you research his afternoon snack.
I hope you don't mind. I'm winning this whole thing.
Yeah, the buckets were pretty bad. Katero-chan, thanks for following. Glad you enjoy. Yeah, I was a little worried that I messed that up. And rightfully so. Okay, I got another one. This makes up for my mistake. God, that was sad.
Graduate with honors.
That's actually quite good.
Imagine not trading.
Happy, the pit is churning.
Like, he dealt that damage face, but if he had traded, I wouldn't have been able to heal the damage back. That turn, so. And he had the ability to heal anyway.
It's perfectly fine.
backfire is good though.
Right, thanks. I know when I've lost.
I could have hit Thralmar Farseer power overwhelming combo. I never did a prediction, did I? I'll do 6. Yeah, thanks everyone for hanging out today. I super appreciate it. If you enjoy, please be sure to hit that follow button. You can also check out the show. Check out my YouTube, where I might post some other Hearthstone content, but it's mostly duels, right? Or it's basically all duels right now.
Willow versus Slate.
What was it that you're working on again?
Professor Slate. What a surprise.
Things are about to take a dark turn.
That's a lot of secrets. That seems like I'm right.
Not my best day on the job.
Could easily be misdirection. Nope. It's open the cages.
Yeah.
So the most important thing is to make sure he doesn't get too... too many. We don't want open the cages to trigger, basically.
Not my best day on the job.
Okay, well, that's gonna make it a little bit more difficult. Okay, should be good to go. We've got a ton of life. Yeah, he's dead. We need one damage to kill him.
Things are about to take a dark turn.
We're gonna add two damage, I guess. I don't like Revenant Rascal at all. We could just go with this middle bucket, maybe. Like, they're okay, but... I mean, Mel'Ganis is just crazy expensive. We still don't know what second passive we're getting. I mean, double battle cry or double legend is good. Double battle cry is good. I mean, Mel'Ganis isn't late game unless you get double legendary. In which case, he's kind of insane because it's 2 11-9s and your hero's immune, unless you kill them both. Bark Maniac, thanks for following.
Professor Slate! What a surprise.
We just really want our early game. I'm not gonna lie and say that, like, you never lack late game with this deck, but you always do lack card draw. Which is basically generally a prerequisite for that deck. A hero cards would probably be good. It depends on the hero cards, like Gul'dan would be great. But
muzzle their magic.
I got this.
But like the shaman one would be terrible.
Ooh, bet there's something great inside.
So it looks like he didn't get freezing. Oh, Hagatha would be good. Yeah, Hagatha would be solid. But, the Death Knight shaman was terrible. I think it was the worst one. By, like, a significant margin. And it's like, the Hunter one was great. Yeah, it's good. It's just typically not good enough, Paradox.
Mind if I roll need?
Unleash me.
My lucky dude.
That's tough.
Your soul is mine.
It's perfectly fine.
Satisfy the soul.
I should have played this first. That was a misorder.
Yeah.
I should have traded before playing the Despicable Dreadlord. I could have missed two damage phase.
I see. Yes.
I must return to the field.
We have so few spells. But yeah, I wouldn't expect the Doubters to win at the moment. It depends if the spell goes off. So what happens is you cast the spell. The imp shows up, and then the spell gets cast again. So, like, a lot of the times you kill it.
Witness the ways of my forest.
Just a warning. I have a black spell.
Be one with nature.
Druid's hero power is insane. Druid is tier 1 because of this hero power. I think they're just gonna consider all of the unnerfs. the balance patch or whatever. I should have. Whatever. I guess spreading it out isn't that bad. I don't know. I think it might be too much with the eyesore, though. Like, Grand Totem Eyesore wasn't in. With Grand Totem Eyesore, I feel like that hero power would be kind of busted. They don't typically balance like that paradox. Like, the game's already borderline spaghetti coded at times. Writing more if statements might not be the answer. All that did was remove one damage from the board. Let's see, we've got 10 plus 19, so this is lethal. Oh wait, no, it actually added damage when he hero powered my minion. No, it kept it this. Kept it the same, I think. Whatever. It was kind of cool how, like, so many different metas developed because they, like, staggered the release of everything. Add deck lists. I post them in Discord. Mostly. I haven't posted one for a while. Because, I mean, most of my deck lists now are just me doing very slight tinkers.
Versus Omu.
Witness the ways of my forest.
Just a warning. I have a black spell.
Probably want to try and get some damage in early. Oh. This is not some pleb we're fighting. Golden C'Thun. Fighting a real man. And it knows how to honor his cards. Oh, yeah, if that's explosive, I'm going to hit the roof. Okay, snipe, that's fine. These three cards all cost at least four.
Better be something good.
Oh my god! I thought about how I needed to attack with this guy first because of Noble Sacrifice, and then I forgot to do it. I thought about it. In my head. And then I was too eager to deal damage to him. I knew I needed to play around Noble Sacrifice. And then I still... How many did that hit? Two. Okay, so he's got a four cost card. So that costs less. And then one of these three cost four. It's a lot. Like, it's already four damage that I lost. Hit three cards. So that one. It's expensive. That hit one.
In time, you too will bloom. Ever bloom.
That was so strong. Yeah, double time is pretty bonkers. Why you don't play Bloom Druid? So, the thing is, like, that's not good for us. It's so bad. Like, I'm considering Canopic Jars far before Chaos Theory. Chaos Theory is so bad for us because it means we don't get our double time. Like,
perfect record.
Hey, you. It's detention time.
Pillars of Fallen is really tough. Damn it. This turn can't be that difficult. At least that's his treasure.
I'll get around.
Wait. What? I'm supposed to get an imp after the second one, I thought. Isn't that how it used to work? It did used to work like that at one point, right, chat? Or am I crazy? Okay, it doesn't? Okay, I thought it did. Why wouldn't it? I guess, oh, it's when, only when you play the card. Fine, I guess I can accept that. But still, I'm sad. But I thought I would still end up with it. Yeah, no, I didn't play it. You guys are right. I'm wrong.
Smart one.
He might have a blade dance. The jars, he just conceded with like 30 health to 3 power on board. I think that's pretty funny. No more context needed. 3 power. I'm that powerful. That 3 attack on my board can intimidate my opponents into conceding. Yeah, he didn't even hero power, or he didn't even kill it to see what was in the box. He was just like, I'm out. This double time shit's too much for me.
Necromancers, all of you.
You're in far over your head, infiltrator.
That'll be an okay turn, too. Man, I miss double time. All you Everyone in chat complained about it nonstop, but I liked it. Because it let me get 12 wins so much.
Out of time.
Holy shit, these are terrible. Except for Rustwix. Okay, that's fine-ish. I would like to understand a little bit more about the lore between this being connections. It's showing an orc looking into a bag of coins, and the informants are freaking turtles. Did the orcs use turtles as informants in WoW at some point? Because I feel like I am missing very necessary information as to why it makes any sense at all. Wait, is that a real thing? Kenny? Because that sounds absurd. Okay. Don't share your fanfiction with chat, Skinny. Because you call it Hearthstone lore doesn't mean it's not just fanfiction.
Yeah, beat it.
Hey, we damaged him. What is this spell saber? Oh, okay, no, I think I see it better. Okay, it's like a girl on top of this incredibly ugly beast. Okay. I couldn't make out what the picture was at all. But it's this girl with horns and gigantic the demon blade thing that you hold. I don't know what it is on her back. You say one less board space by playing it. I say one more hand space and plus one health. It's a glaive, okay. Wait, are you sure that's a glaive? I thought a glaive was like the gigantic ninja star that Huntress threw in World of War, in Warcraft 3.
There once was a man from Gildas.
A glaive is a sword on a stick. Aren't all swords on a stick?
Out of time.
Ugh, is this really necessary?
We probably should have just like fire breather there.
The pit is churning.
Yeah, I should have played Fire Breather. Missed out on some damage. Missed out on a lot of damage, actually. But I mean, he might go what? Does he not know? He doesn't know, chat, that refresh and game are two separate words.
This is our time, scrub.
Yeah, beat it.
This is our time, scrub.
Yeah, beat it.
Imagine if he had an edge. Oh. Isn't that cute? That little 8-8 over there.
It's perfectly harmless.
Hey, Swag Bomber. Hey, were you guys here earlier when I killed myself in an unlosable position, thanks to Solarian Prime? Restef, thanks for following. Oh yeah, Dietak gifted a bunch of subs, which helped raise the number, but yeah. Nice. Ooh. Actually, like, we have a pretty minion-based deck. I don't know, Sow the Seeds could actually be kind of interesting, too. Like, I typically like Coin Pouch with Double Time. But Sow the Seeds seems pretty good. I'll go clunk out. Wait, I really like coin, or is it called coin pouch? Yeah, coin pouch. I can sometimes mix up the name with Bag of Coins. Okay, so we need some early game. Because he's gonna be coming in hard.
You're in far over your head, infiltrator.
We either need card draw or just like insane development on our board. Okay, I mean, we got a curve. Double battle cry probably won't be too devastating in Rogue.
Muzzle their magic.
Better be something good.
So here's a question, chat. If we top deck Philosophy, do we play it?
Hey, loser.
Or do we just go straight into Demonizer? And hope that one of the minions off Demonizer is worth the double Philosophy. Also, fuck that pen flinger. Well, because I wouldn't be able to play it for a turn, is what I'm saying.
My lucky dudes!
Shit, it's plagiarism! It's plagiarism! He has our Demonizer! Demonizer is a really good card.
What was that?
Yeah, that's... Oh my god, and it has double battle cry. If he's ever capable of emptying his hand.
Hey, loser!
It's upgraded based on how many games you've played, so it'll be the same for him.
Hey, loser!
Dude, what if you didn't get a one mana spell? Bruh. No, all he wants is the room, apparently. I hope he got your axis there. Okay, that was a little BM. But I mean, I was attacking his face. I mean, you gotta learn how. That's how. How do you think you learn how to do complicated turns? You practice. At least he mulliganed that card away. That gives me a little bit of hope. Wait, did he just... Oh, okay. I guess that makes sense. Okay. Okay, okay. Okay, our hand is a little full. Maybe that was a mistake. I was like, I wouldn't mind getting like 1-1. They nerfed Killmox twice. Oh, I forgot that I had double time with that. Maybe I could have saved it. Okay, I'm gonna only get 4 demons. And 4 demons isn't terrible. Or I could just Fire Breather. They made it cost 7. Don't you dare power. Okay. Still, this is very bad considering I just played Fire Breather. Okay, maybe I go Fire Breather again, chat.
It's perfectly fine.
Of the essence.
So we will never run out of cards, basically, almost, with three demonizers.
Behold the rage of the Firelands.
Dude, Butch is pretty kecked up. I mean, it depends what that secret is a little bit. I want to play it because of Spellbender.
Thank you.
Wait, I messed up. Okay, everything's fine. Yeah. I ruined everything. So much. At least Moros isn't gonna screw me over.
The Scourge will devour all! Are you ready for this?
I always win.
I'll get around.
Come closer.
Do you see what must be done?
His 5-5 treants are going to suck. Wait, they're 6-6s? I thought he's only played 3 of them. So they're 5-5s.
Free your mind from its bonds.
I was taken into account. Yeah, I knew it was in hand because he got it, because I went for the Canopic Jars play instead of the Abyssal Enforcer play.
up for the tour?
The widow embraces me.
Why do I bother? Why do I bother?
I mean, this is what games at 10-0 look like. You just gotta outlast them.
Aren't you?
Just for show.
I mean, I wouldn't give up if I were him. Like, he stayed in the game this long. You just keep fighting.
Drink up, my children.
Hey, look at that. That was insane. His staff has been absolutely absurd. Yeah, I'm actually concerned now. He duplicated his Goru because I went for a Canopic Jars play. What? Okay, I thought it disappeared first, or the green disappeared for a second. Okay. I did lose coin purse. And he's gonna get the draw he's gonna do. That's not great.
My hatred burns!
As you wish.
Draxus takes away all of my armor, which puts me in a very difficult position. I actually have no idea how to win this. No. Well, I mean, ideally he runs out of minions eventually, but that's not what's happening. What spells cost 9? Oh shit. Plague of death isn't in. Plagues are not in. One, two, three, four, five. 4, 28, 40. I don't have any 5-cost spells to turn into Twisting Nether. Seriously, what? What spells cost 9? Any spells. Librem of Hope isn't in? I'm looking for spells in the pool that are playable. Okay, we're dead. But those spells you can't put in your starting deck. Plagues are from Saviors of Odum. No one has said a single 9 mana spell. Okay, a 9 mana spell that Deck of Lunacy can transform my deck into. Like, if you say plague, I will time you out for a week. Because that is not an expansion in duels. Okay, giving you 10 minutes. Why? Well, you're on delay, so when I said I'll time you out for a week, I said that before. Or I said it after you typed it, I think. I think it was you typing it that triggered me, like, I was like, hello, guys, Slate. Please learn.
What was it that you're working on again?
Professor Slate, what a surprise.
That is not an acceptable answer.
You here for the tour?
It's tough after 6 hours to keep up the level of play. Because, I mean, I could have... I should have won that game. I played it poorly. The Canopic Jurist play was so bad because, like, I couldn't get 2 legendaries. Hello, Hisar. Tree of Life was goblins versus gnomes. I believe. There's a chance it was Grand Tournament, but I think it was Goblins versus them. God, he just followed. Maybe I shouldn't time him out for 10 minutes, chat. He just followed a minute ago. So, if you're unaware, Pinchy, like 15 people have said Plague of Death and it's not in rotation. And it was driving me insane, so I had to take drastic measures. That's not being a bully. It's... me trying to maintain some semblance of sanity. Just don't shoot mine. Okay. Thank you, Mighty Storm. I didn't think so. So, like, I don't know what he's gonna have to refuel here. Hopefully I don't draw a, Fragment. And this isn't. If that was any other. My best day on the job. I was worried about Unleash. Am I dead now? He has to trade in 3, unless he has a skill. Wouldn't you just skill command my face after trading 3 in? I mean, he's got so many ways to kill me here. Does he know he's still one off?
Oh, I'm low on time.
And that math has failed him completely.
Perfectly fine.
I'm pretty sure it was possible for him to kill me. But I would have to go back and do math. That's not what I wanted to do. I really probably should have thought this through slightly better.
It's perfectly harmless to me.
Not my best day on the job.
Disappointing!
It's perfectly harmless to me.
And we still have to keep going. I want this run over. I want this run over. I'm so sad. The Quildor piece we got the first turn was... we can do bets, though, on if I'll get 12 wins. But yes, again, if anyone that's new here, I can almost type it. If you enjoy duels at all, make sure you follow the stream. Also, I post duels videos every day that I don't mess up. I stream duels most days.
Witness the ways of my forest.
I do not play
just
when I'm not streaming.
Warning, I have a black thumb.
This is tricky. Like, you have to start so fast. Do I still do this? I really just want to be able to dump it from my hand. A lot of people enjoy watching Battlegrounds, though, is the thing. It's a pretty big thing.
It's perfectly fine.
But I don't know. I do disagree. I feel like a lot of people stream Battlegrounds that shouldn't be. Like, I feel like if you have, like, less than 5 viewers, unless you're, like, top 25 on the leaderboard, you shouldn't be streaming Battlegrounds.
You are not the boss of me!
Because no one's gonna find you there. They didn't pay them to play Battlegrounds. Like, RDU doesn't... RDU gets like 1,000 viewers if he streams Constructed, and like 4,000 if he streams Battlegrounds. So he's gonna stream
Where shall I strike?
Okay, so this is when you go Canopic Jars. Those are quite the high rolls. Those are so bad.
I've been inside that thing for months.
Please don't have wand.
Some thrive, some will.
But yeah, I mean, Battleground, it's just like a completely separate game. Like, there are transferable skills between, like, Arena Battleground, or Arena Standard, and, I just want to heal. Like, Arena Standard and Duels, like, the skills are transferable, whereas, like, if you're good in Standard, it doesn't mean you're good at Battlegrounds. Absolutely not, Drizzle. You always go Cannibalism and Druid. Coin Pouch is good, but I don't know, Mage Armor seems like it could be really nice to be 20 health. Yeah, but I mean, people complain about the RNG in duels as well, but over thousands of games, it's gonna even out for sure.
Versus Rattlegore!
But,
How can I kill what's already dead?
If anything, I would say standard. Standard and rare probably do have. No, standard has the least RNG, I would say. Which is probably why people find it boring. That out of here. Maybe I shouldn't have played it.
Salutations.
Job done.
Yeah, he does have the C'Thun, but still, he definitely didn't skip every time. We're gonna burn a lot of cards. No! No. It was, I think, we burned a pouch. Or a coin pouch, I think. Oh my god. Fuck this game.
Do try to keep yourselves alive!
Burn occurred. You know, so it goes, you summon a 3/3, or a 3 cost minion, and then a 6 cost minion, and then a 3, 6, and 9 cost minion.
Here for a good time. Here for a good time.
Whoa. I'm burning cards because I can't get them out of my hand fast enough. We're in pretty big trouble once he starts playing the legendaries. Like, he's gonna have played this so many times that his Groms will just instantly kill me. You know, unless he has a single board clear, then it's not really... Top deck, like, if I could get an envoy, that'd be really cool. But maybe I still want to go taunt. Build the wall. There's Brawl and Wand, and that's probably it.
For a good time.
Oh yeah, and Barov. He already played a Barov though. Appears to have messed up chat. In love with Duxings for fine. And we didn't get the 12-0 I was hoping for. But we did get there. If you are watching this beautiful run on YouTube. Please be sure you like, subscribe, comment, ring the bell. Let me know the last time you got double time. How that was. You check me out every day on twitch.tv/teamamerica. Thanks for watching.